Okay, so before I get into this match, I would like to welcome those who came from Molvone19's channel. And I'd also like to thank Molvone19 himself for the SOS and whatnot. So, yeah. But anyways, how's it going, YouTube? Dallasboi here, backing up with another Pokemon Black and White 2 Wi-Fi battle. Today's match is going to be against dbzmariogeno. We had this battle over Skype. And if you are one of those people that's kind of expecting a serious matchup, please close the tab right now. Because, if you guys don't know me, I am a big fan of silly matches like this, where you just bring some random stuff from your boxes. And by random, I mean really, really, really bad sets. So, yeah. But anyways, looking at teams, he's got some random junk. I've got even more random junk. He's only got one NU on his team, and I got things like Kakuna, Azurill, Wigglytuff. So, it looks like I'm at a very, very big disadvantage at this point, but we'll see how this match goes. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this battle, and let's get this show on the road. So, to start off, he's going to be leading off with his Darmanitan Zen mode, and I actually get to lead off with my special attacking Durant. I go for an HP bug here, because I have nothing that wants to take an attack from this thing. So, I felt that this Durant would be the best thing to sack. Sorry, Will, but I just had to sack this thing. It was for the greater good. But after that, this Darmanitan just goes flat out straight into its normal form. So, seeing as it's a special attacker, I can just go into my Wigglytuff and try to set up some screens. I get up a light screen right here, and yeah, Golurk not looking like a favorable matchup with Wigglytuff here, so I'm just going to be switching into my Cofagrigus, trying to sponge Focus Punch, which I do thanks to my ghost typing. And here he's just going to be sending out his Kyurem Regular right here, and I'd get off a Choice Spec Shadow Ball. And if any of you think this is a good idea, I wouldn't recommend it. But anyways, he's just going to be going for the Ice Beam. Does a reasonable chunk, and I am able to KO this thing with an Ice Beam because I get a max damage roll. So he's going to be going into his Darmanitan Zen mode again. He misses Fire Blast, and that's going to be coming into a little bit of play later, as you will see later on in the battle. I get to smack that thing with the Shadow Ball, and Darmanitan Zen mode is gone. So Porygon 2 comes in as he finally figures out that I'm a spec set. So, I'm just going to be going out into the Elastic Waistband as he just flat out goes for a Toxic on me. And my Wigglytuff is kind of crippled at this point. But I can actually set up a Reflect on the Porygon 2. Oh, no, wait. I just flat out go for a Seismic Toss thinking that it would do nothing. But he just sends out his Landorus Theory in form. And this is pretty much going to cause me a set up Reflect, I guess. I kind of thought that he would either sub or just set up rocks, I guess. My bad. This narration is completely unprofessional right now. But he's going to be going up or setting up a Swords Dance. I'm just going to be setting up Light Screen. Just whatever I bring in is supported ideally. And I can just sponge whatever. So now I'm finally going to be going into my Landorus Therian form, get off and Intimidate on this thing, and he just sets up a Substitute. And this is looking like a Sub-SD Gravity Earthquake set, while I am a sub-bulk up set of Landorus. It would be reasonable why this thing could have some viability, but then again, bulk up on Landorus Therian form, not the best. This thing is just best at being a defensive pivot. And here I go for a Stone Edge. Don't know why. Earthquake, the gravity's up. An Earthquake would be a viable option at this point. But, yeah, hindsight's 20/20, I guess. But here gravity returns normal. And I'm just thinking he's going to set up again. So I just set up a Substitute. And I have a Reflect and a plus one bulk up. So, and his Landorus is pretty much uncovered, so I can just fire off an Earthquake here, which I could have done earlier, but no, but Harry, it just flat out, his land prestige just flat out goes down. And now he's going to be sending out his Porygon 2, which he's going to be using to kind of stall out the gravity, I guess. But, here he's just going to be, taking an earthquake pretty well, and he fires off an ice beam, and, yeah, that's going to prompt me to switch out into whatever I feel. No, I don't switch out, because I get too cocky with the, light screen, and I just tank the hit with 98 HP, and, yeah, and due to the prior damage, I actually get to take this Porygon 2 out. Sorry, guys, I kind of thought that he would have been dead, but anyways, the lack of gravity gives him the opportunity to send him Crobat, as I'm no longer able to go for an earthquake on this thing. I miss the Stone Edge after he heat waves me, and I just lose my Lander Searing Form, and it's looked like a Crobat sweep, except for the fact that he gets greedy, goes for Nasty Plot, and Bouncy the Azurill actually gets up a Double Edge, and look at how much this does. Oko. Choice banded Azurill. With huge power and all, Oko's a Crobat. Which is really impressive, and I wanted to save face on this Azurill, because it did. It was the star of the show right there. But now Golurk's going to be going for an earthquake, because if it locks itself in the Shadow Punch, if it locks itself in the Focus Punch, yeah, he pretty much auto loses right there. And here's where the Fire Blast miss came into play. Due to that, I'm able to live the earthquake with 17 HP and retaliate with a Spec Shadow Ball, and Golurk just dies, and that's the game. So, yeah, fun little dirt match, and I would have liked it if Golurk did live the Shadow Ball with just a nub of HP. Could have gone for Energy Ball, but just wanted the safer win, I guess. And would have been nice so I could have gotten a game-winning kill with Kakuna, but what can you do? But that was a little fun little dirt match, DBZ Mariogeno, and rate, comment, sub, and I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.